Hello everyone. This lesson will introduce you to a significant application of public key cryptography, the digital adaptation of handwritten signatures. In this lesson, you will learn the advantages and objectives of digital signatures and review digital signature schemes step by step. Handwritten signatures, in one form or another, as a simple X or an intricate calligraphic creation, have been around for centuries and have always belonged to a person. For example, this is how Alan Turing would sign his research in letters. Anyone seeing the document would know that he was the one to sign it. One issue here, though, is that handwritten signatures like this are easy to forge. Even more sophisticated ones can fall victim to a good calligraphist. The digital counterpart to handwritten signatures, opportunely, has several advantages over them. Digital signatures are capable of providing better means of authentication of the identity of the signer. The signature depends on a secret known only to the signer, their private key. This way, digital signatures also ensure non-repudiation. A signer cannot at a later time claim they did not create the signature because it is tied to their private key, so no one else could have done it, unless the key is suspected to have been stolen. Digital signatures also depend on the information itself, indirectly providing data integrity. The input data is usually hashed first to detect intentional or accidental modifications. Like in this example, if I try to attach the same signature to a different message, the verification will not pass. Digital signatures can be generated on both the data that is transmitted or the data that is stored. A digital signature scheme is similar to a public key encryption system, but with a major conceptual difference. To sign some information, Alice uses her private key, and Bob will be able to verify the validity of the signature using Alice's public key. The use of private and public keys in signature is in a sense similar to that of encryption, where Bob would encrypt with Alice's public key something only she can decrypt, though in this case, Alice sends something only she could have signed. It is important to know that by definition, asymmetric encryption and signing are related, but in practice, however, some public key cryptography algorithms are better for one than the other. For example, the elliptic curve digital signature algorithm, ECDSA, uses private and public key pairs, but as the name suggests, it is only defined for use in digital signing, while RSA may be used for both encryption and signing. So in our encrypt, we will get an error message if we try to do that with elliptic curves. When encrypted with a public key, the encrypted data can be sent by a secure channel without risk. No matter how many encrypted messages attackers intercept, they cannot decrypt them without the correct private key. Similarly, a public key digital signature system has to be resistant to forgery. No matter how many valid message signature pairs attackers collect, they should not be able to create valid signatures in Alice's name without her private key. Signed data, as opposed to encrypted data, may not have a specific recipient. It could be posted publicly for anyone to verify. The digital signature is usually provided alongside the signed data. And the verifying entity verifies the signature using the claimed signer's public key. For example, Alice wishes to share with the world some of her research results, like this graph. She takes her private key, obtained with generate asymmetric key pair or imported from a file she already had before, and creates a signature for the graph with the private key, and posts it publicly, for example to her Wolfram crowd page. For any fellow researcher to be able to verify the signature, they need to know Alice's public key too, so she shares it as well on her cloud. Now her colleagues, who have these links, can download the graph, the signature, and the public key, and verify if the signature was truly created by Alice for this specific graph result. As you would expect, the signature no longer verifies true for a different public key. Thanks to all the aforementioned properties, digital signatures are now used by both private and state organizations, For publishing official electronic documents, official email communications, contracts, software distribution, or funds transfer transactions between banks and decentralized systems like cryptocurrencies. Several industries, such as automotive and healthcare, have developed specific standards for digital identity and signatures between the members of the industry and regulatory organizations. Digital signatures also have legal value in many countries, like the European Union Digital Identity of the Citizens. The next lessons will cover two of the most famous algorithms in asymmetric cryptography, RSA and elliptic curves, and show how they relate to digital signatures and encryption.